Living and working in a microgravity environment requires culinary ingenuity and creativity. Did you know that bread is prohibited on the International Space Station, ISS? This is because it produces crumbs that become unmanageable when floating about the space station. The solution, tortillas. Did you know that your sense of taste can change while in microgravity? A favorite food item on Earth can taste terrible in space. In the early days of spaceflight, Mercury astronauts would consume puree squeezed from tubes and cubes of dry goods. Astronaut John Glenn was the first to eat in space, proving that swallowing and digestion are possible in microgravity. During the Gemini missions, astronauts began consuming freeze-dried food and powdered beverages, which they rehydrated with cold water before consumption. The Apollo program continued to use freeze-dried food and powdered drinks, but with the luxury of hot water if desired. These meals, similar to meals, ready-to-eat, MREs, used by the United States Armed Forces, are still used today, but with improved taste, texture, and options. Food preparation process. Food for NASA's current astronauts is prepared and packaged at the Space Food Systems Laboratory at Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. There, astronauts select the meals they would like for their mission. The lab creates nutritious food, ensuring peak health and performance for the crew, and is an essential entity for the research and development of meals for long-duration missions of up to 5 years. Long missions require space foods to have a long shelf life, meaning eating after months or years at ambient or room temperature is safe. When most people think of space food, they think of astronaut ice cream, which is ice cream that has undergone the food preservation process called freeze-drying. The first step of the freeze-drying process involves freezing fully prepared food at approximately minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Next, the food is put into a vacuum chamber and heated so the water content of the food sublimates or transforms directly from a solid, ice, to a gas, water vapor. The water vapor is sucked out of the vacuum chamber. The process is repeated as many times as necessary to remove nearly all the food's water content. This process kills some but not all bacteria, however, it does stop bacteria from multiplying and spoiling the food. It essentially leaves the food frozen in time. Additional benefits of freeze-drying are that it drastically reduces the weight of the food item, which means a lighter payload for launch, and it preserves the most nutrients and is easier to rehydrate when compared to other preservation methods. Other standard processes that ensure the longevity of space food are thermostabilization, which exposes cans or pouches to high heat and pressure, and irradiation, which exposes food and packaging to ionizing radiation. Both processes eliminate bacteria that could spoil the food, compromise its shelf life and make it inconsumable. Astronauts may also eat normal pantry goods in their natural form such as nuts, granola bars, candies, cookies and more, repackaged at the Space Food Systems Laboratory. Space food commonly comes in plastic packaging or cans. To prevent their food from floating away at meal time, packaging has Velcro patches so it can be attached to a tray or table. Tape, tethers, and magnets are also used to affix food items to surfaces. Additionally, meal time on the ISS requires an additional utensil we typically don't keep at the dinner table on Earth. Scissors are an essential utensil for opening the vacuum-sealed bags and retort pouches in which space food is packaged. One might think that soup is not an option for astronauts, however, foods with higher water content aren't too much of a problem. The liquid generally stays attached to its package and the utensil used to eat it because of surface tension. However, when drinking rehydrated beverages from a pouch, specially adapted straws are important. The straws have a clasp to prevent liquid from floating out of the straw. This is different than eating soup out of a package, as once the water travels up the straw, it has very little surface to cling to and can float away. For the same reason that bread is not allowed on the ISS, astronauts cannot season their food with standard ground spices. Pepper tastes much better in your mouth than it does floating into your eyes. The solution: package the seasonings in liquid form. After the meal is complete, cleaning up is a little different. There's no soapy sink to wash your hands and utensils. Astronauts will use disinfectant wipes or gently squeeze some water and diluted liquid soap onto their skin, then towel the excess water off. When throwing away their food packaging, it's important that astronauts consume the entirety of their meals. This is to ensure they get sufficient calories, but also to prevent the extra food from spoiling and creating smelly garbage on the ISS.